You want to go down to Florida?
Yeah. Yes, I do.
We cover a lot of weird Florida stories on the show. It is time for another Florida story. Here we go!
Attention all listeners of the Freak Show. It's time to travel to the Sunshine State.
Yes!
It happened again.
It's another Florida story. Spring Hill, Florida for this next story. We have a guy who's, something's wrong with him. He's not in his right mind.
Yeah.
And he's at a bank drive-thru, uh-huh. Okay?
Hernando County Sheriff's deputies say the manager of the bank found this man, 28-year-old Douglas Francisco, asleep behind the wheel of a car in a bank drive-thru.
All right, he's sleeping in the bank drive-thru. This
Doug, man, come on.
What's going on here?
The manager says when he tried to wake this guy up, uh-oh, this guy beat on the window and asked the manager, a bank manager, for a burrito.
There it is. I love how Florida stories escalate. It's like the slow build, right? Like, officers found this guy sleeping, bank drive-thru. Like, wow, how do you fall asleep in a bank drive-thru?
Bank guy's just on the little microphone. Sir.
Woke him up.
Wake up.
And he asked for a burrito.
After the bank manager told him it wasn't Taco Bell.
Not Taco Bell, man.
This guy took off.
Oh. And he's gone. And he's gone just like that.
Deputies say when they tracked him down, surprise, he failed a field sobriety test.
According to the arrest report, he made several unusual statements, including that he wanted a burrito, and he thought he was at Taco Bell, and he was at a bank drive-thru. By the way, hold on, let's think of this here. How great would it be if you go to the bank drive-thru, and they send you a burrito through that tube? Like the whoosh tube?
It's like that whoosh tube should be made for delivering burritos.
It really should be. That'd be amazing, right? All right, imagine the aluminum foil wrap. Like you go to Chipotle or something like that. You get that. Like they could, I feel like they could send that through the bank chute.
Wrap it tight.
Oh, man. They are, whoosh. I mean, they're like aluminum foil missiles, those things. Yeah. I feel like they wrap those well enough to where it could withstand the bank tube whoosh. Whoa, there could be a business here. There could be a multi-million dollar business here. Listen, I love burritos, but I usually don't go to a burrito place because I just don't like dealing with people. I'm socially awkward. I don't like going up to the front and having to ask what I want.
Well, I mean, a lot of times line's really long too at most of those places.
I just don't like dealing with that. I'm socially awkward. Let me tell you how much money a place would get if it was like a bank drive-thru but with burritos.
A burrito shoot?
Oh, whoosh. Every day. Every day I'd go and ask for burritos. I'm telling you, this guy was in the future, man. This guy was not sleeping in this bank drive-thru in 2018.
He did so much Florida, he was in the future.
He was in 2035.
Was he on drugs? Do we know? Was he on drugs?
Let's see. He made several unusual statements. He had delayed reactions as well as slowed movements. Consistent with somebody under the influence of prescription narcotics. He failed field sobriety exercises. He was under arrest. States that he had oxycodone and Xanax on him, both of which were prescribed. So this guy might have only been taking regular pain medicine than he was described. Prescribed.
I mean, he was just seeing the future, and it freaked him out.
I know the opioid crisis is a big thing in America right now, but there has never been a more powerful statement about, you know, overdosing and watching the pain medicine you take other than a man in Florida pulled up to a bank drive-through thinking he was going to get burritos. You got to be careful with those pain meds because it took him to 2035, and he has the greatest business idea ever.